Hello everybody, my name is Pascal Noel and this is a tutorial video for the Advanced Video Clip Manager Clipbox. If you don't already own Clipbox, go to nohl.lu and download your copy for free. So here we go! Clipbox features two completely different ways to find similar files. The first one focuses on tags. It tries to find movies with the same or very similar tags than the reference movie. The second tries to find movies that have a similar content, so where the movie pictures are similar one to the other. Now let's take a look at the search by tag similarity. You can choose between by approximation or by inclusion. I will choose by approximation. You see that the return search contains all files. Our reference movie has a 100% green bar, and our similar movie has also 100% green bar, and all other movies have red bars. To understand the logic, we have here tags. One is kind cars. Quality high and rating 5 stars. In our similar movie we have also kind cars and quality good. So by approximation ignores all the other tags but only finds the common tags. In this example here, both movies have a common tag cars, but all the other movies have no tags. So this is the most similar movie to this one by tag content. You can exit this mode here. Now let's try the same thing but with the menu inclusion. You see that the returned result is nearly the same, but this time the green bar here is only at 50%. This 50% are not in relation to the tags, but it is 50% more similar than all the other movies. This bar just gives you a ranking compared to all the other movies. By the inclusion, also the not same tags are considered for the result. This logic may seem complicated, but after using it several times, you will find it very convenient. Now let's take a look at the Find Similar Advanced Multi-Compare. So you can choose between comparing this clip to all the other clips, comparing selected clips to the clips of the inbox, compare all clips from the inbox to all the other clips, or compare each clip to each other one. For this tutorial, we'll compare the selected clip with all the other clips. You can also choose here the Hamming difference. The Hamming difference is a technical term for the proximity. So setting it to the right will return only more similar movies, so more accurate results, but will miss some movies that are similar but not similar enough. So even the setting to the left here will give you good results, but if you need to narrow it down, you can drag this slider more to the right. So let's try it. The viewer for this kind of search is a little bit different. We see the found movies here. By clicking on the movie on the list, the found movies are shown. You can have more items here if more movies are compared to others. So here are the two movies. We can take a look at them. They are very similar or nearly identical. How is it possible that this movie has been imported, remembering that the fingerprint does not allow to import identical movies? Let's take a look at the info panel here and let's switch from one to the other. We see that there are some changes. Here we have a video bitrate that is lower than this one here. We have 631 frames. We have 504 frames here. So while the movie seems to be the same, it isn't the same because the video bitrate is different and so on. Remember that I told you that the fingerprint only identifies movies that are bit by bit the same. So this function is really useful to find similar movies. From here you can either delete the file or delete it and mark it as spam. I'm doing nothing here, so I exit the search here. Here you are seeing a real-time dialog of this function where 48 files are compared to more than 14,000 other movie files, some files having several gigabytes, and you can see that the real-time speed is really impressive. We are now at the end of this tutorial, and in the next tutorial I'll show you how to handle changes with external editors.